again. See what happens here. I'm on locals today, believe it or not. I've been doing it all sodding day. I've done two Liverpools, a collection in ADOC. And now I'm going to asda Warrington. And it's blowing a gale still. I can do without this. Being kept local like this because I'm losing money all the time. Not. You gotta take the rough with the extra rough. Try and get my wagon into Scania tomorrow, being Friday, to see what's wrong with it for the second time. I hold no hope out whatsoever. Nobody wants to pay. Last Friday, came out, lasted a day, so we shall see what happens this Friday. No doubt it'll be Friday night. Building me hopes up. The only thing I'm really hoping for is this wind to die down, because it's what next drops open all the curtains up as well. Splendid. Still, look on the bright side, it isn't raining. Forward to is my tea tonight. Probably be another night in the yard. Don't get me wrong, I can go home, but it means going home, cooking my tea at home, then coming back to work at stupid o'clock in the morning, talking like getting up at 3 o'clock in the morning. It's just not worth the grief. It wakes the missus up, me banging around the house at that time of the morning. Grief. The trouble is I lose my night out money every time I spend the night in the yard. So instead of getting 20 odd quid for sleeping in the cab, I still sleep in the cab for nothing, but it saves me a lot of grief, so basically I just do it. This is not a whinge, by the way, this is just how it is. Side, I'm getting plenty of exercise, in and out, opening curtains, general divvying about, which is not a bad thing, because when you're on long distance, it's just drive, drive, and more drive. place all day. Easy enough, but not very good for your health.
Thank you.
buzzing around there, that's for sure. Call windy. I'm not a big fan of this junction neither, because nobody seems to know where they go inland. Let's just cross from that one to this one. Thanks for the heads up, like the indicators and stuff. Not. This bend we're coming to here, for some reason wagons turn over on it a lot. As you can see by the barrier there, they must come flying round here and then way straight over. I think it's the camber in the road, it tilts in. Domino's Pizza Factory. They've got a new way of getting in now. You have to put a load of numbers into a bloody touchpad that's knackered because drivers have been punching hell out of it. Let's see how we go this time. Stuck behind somebody, huh? Not good. See up the side of his trailer there. They're having to tap a load of numbers into it. It's alright if you've got the reach of an orangutan. Thank you.
hate this machine.
Windy.
04 55 886.
You need to sort that keypad out. I'll be poking your finger off trying to get that thing to work. The annoying part is with that, it recognises my registration, tells me what it is, and when I go to OK it won't have it. Because it's only three letters, I have to put a gap in it for it to register it. It's a bit annoying when you're trying to not cave your rib cage in, leaning outside the door. They didn't think that through when they stuck that system in, that's for sure. Proper wide open here, so it blows a sodding gale at the best of times. At least there's plenty of room over there for me to get in. This asda that's coming up behind me now won't wait. I'll have to wait for him. Just go steaming past me. Cans are all over the place. And that's the end of that. I have to go and book in now, so